German.
To see my mum and all her family and all the rest of the judo team. It's not over yet, we've got all the other lads have got a fight yet. I'm going to have a couple of months off, I think, now and do my studies because I'm hoping to go to Telford Tech for music degree. So take some time out to do that, I think. And then the next is the Europeans again, which we've got the defending title, European champion.
All right, best of luck and congratulations. It was a great fight.
Thanks a lot.
If I get a 10-point score, it's over in 5 seconds. Just the way it goes.
Wonderful occasion, especially for Simon Jackson and the British team as they enter the Olympic Stadium. Plenty of support for them. A lot expected of them. Conditions almost perfect. A long ceremony.
Can't believe it, honest to God, it's
Jackson arrived in Atlanta with the same strong self-belief that he had when he won his first gold as a 16-year-old in Seoul. He hasn't been beaten.
And it's thanks to all these guys over here.
You've had some terrific support.
It's been brilliant. Everybody's been behind me. I'd just like to thank a few people. I'd like to thank everybody in Littleborough, Nurses on the Hunt Award, all the people at the Week Seat, Prince. It was really special, yeah.
Mobile phones may very well have decreased in size over the years. In contrast, Simon has increased, going up a weight category in consecutive games. 60 kilograms in Seoul, 71 kilograms in Barcelona, 78 in Atlanta, and 81 here in Sydney.
I was still a baby in Seoul. I was 20 years old in Barcelona. I weighed 11 stone 6 pounds. Then I went up for Atlanta to 12 stone 4, and now I'm at the 12 stone 10 division. So it's just a natural thing, really. It's not I've intentionally gone up the weights. It's just, you know, my body's going bigger and I'm maturing.
Some people are born shy and retiring. Not this one, though. The lad from Littleborough has always been supremely confident. His desire for victory has never waned, even when his back was against the wall.
I went to the Europeans 2 years ago in Italy. This guy threw me for a 7-point score in 3 seconds. So in judo, to win a contest outright, you have to win by 10 points. So he's got 7 points on the board. And the Italian crowd are going absolutely mad because it's like the first time I've ever been really down a really big score. So this was like 3 seconds, he's got this 7 point. And I absolutely battered him for 5 minutes. I mean, I picked him up, threw him, and I couldn't get this score back. And my coach shouted out, "Si, there's 10 seconds left." So we started fighting again. I threw him to the ground, I got a strangle on him, I strangled him and he submitted with 3 seconds left on the board.
In 12 years, he hasn't lost a single bout. And although his Sydney draw brings him up face to face with both his arch rivals, Gabor Vincenzo from Hungary and Alonso Cruz of Cuba, he remains unfazed.
Those two players, I'd say, are the two biggest threats to my Paralympic title. But it's a good thing because I get rid of the Hungarian first fight, get rid of the Cuban in the semi-final, nice easy final.
Judo at the Paras is the sole domain of the vision impaired, and it brings the sport into a whole new dimension.
Judo is an ideal sport for partially sighted and blind people because it's feel. If you feel your opponent making his attempt for a throw, or you feel him making a foot sweep or a leg grab, it's better. I can sense when someone's going to try and throw me before they actually do it.
So how much can Simon actually see?
People always ask me what I can see, but I don't actually know what you can see, so I can't actually say that. And, you know, they say, is it blurred? Well, it's not blurred to me. But I can't see at all at night. I can't read small print, but I can see enough to get hold of a big Hungarian and throw him out of it.
Explosive.
Now that you've had time to consider it and you've picked yourself up again, in a way, does it take the pressure off that you finally have been beaten?
Definitely. I have enjoyed this games so much. I knew it were coming.
Everything there was to win, 3 or 4 times over. So the pressure was immense. It did get to me. It got to me.
British coach Steve Pullen believes Jackson is in gold medal shape and will eradicate the memory of Sydney.
The problem is he didn't just lose, he lost to a billion people. Everybody was watching, that was the hardest thing. And it took me 20 minutes to get him back on the mat, and he came back, he won a bronze. I mean, that was the hardest thing. I mean, people don't realise when he won a bronze, it was that good. And he came back from completely being defeated, and he bounced right back.
Though judo is an individual sport, the British squad has always displayed a sense of unity, with Jackson the inspiration.
We've put the dedication in, and we've put the work in,
And with lottery funding, which has been, you know, immense, which has helped, enabled us to travel all around the world and get the best practices, you know, I think the team in a whole, as a whole, is going to do very well. And I think, you know, it shouldn't be measured off who gets the gold medals. It's measured off who does the personal best and who competes better than they're expected to compete. And I think myself and the three players behind me, I think we're going to compete.
Pretty impressive. You're improving.
Yeah, it was five in Barcelona, so I thought I'd take my time a little bit more. Give him something to watch. You know, my dad watched it in Barcelona. He travelled all that way for 5 seconds, so he said, I'm going to Atlanta, take a bit more time, will you? So, you know, it messed me her up a little bit, though, but that gave me the breaks.
But your third Olympic gold, I mean, you obviously enjoy the competition.
No, I hate it. No, I love it. I'm a bit sorry to hear that Steve's going to jump back in a boat, because I'm going for my fourth in Sydney, Steve. And that means I've got to go to the next one to equal you. So, can you retire, please?
Now listen, I've heard 82 fights in 10 years.
86.
86 now, 86. Undefeated.
Yeah.
What's the secret of your success?
I train hard. Seeing Steve in a boat at 6 o'clock in the morning. I don't jump in a boat, but I jump on a judo mat early. I'm dedicated. Judo is my life. Which is a bit sad, I suppose. But, I do go out as well now and again. chase as many girls as I can. I must protest, though, you look very nice tonight.
What are you
but
saying?
Don't take it as too much of a compliment. I'm visually impaired.
I think it's time for me to swiftly move on. Sarah, tremendous success for the British team. I'm going to escort Simon back to his seat now. But ladies and gentlemen, our Paralympians.